nuestro no volví a llorar. Alguien, por favor, le cuente la verdad, que ya tomé un remedio pa' mi corazón. No lo he vuelto a ver, no sé a dónde fue. Díganle que jamás. Hey guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and pretty much I always do get ready with me. So today I'm gonna do how to get ready with me, I guess. So I took off my ponytail, I brushed my hair, obviously. That's why I love doing braids, because let me tell you, ever since when I got my surgery done, that morning I had my braids put in, and then I just left them in for like 3 days. And then I obviously showered, and then I did my braids again. I mean, I wash my hair every third day. So that's what I've been doing. And alright, so once you have your hair brushed, I pretty much just go right in the middle. And then I've been using this little Hawaiian silk. You get this at Sally's. I love it a lot. I like to put this towards the end of my hair, well, halfway, and then towards the end. And then I brush it just to make sure that it's put well. Okay. And then I like to braid it. The way that I braid this hair doesn't really matter, because I'm not going to be, you know, pretty much having these braids right now. I mean, tomorrow. They're just for me to sleep in, so I don't really worry particularly how they look, unless I'm going somewhere. The only thing that I really do worry about is just making it tight, because you want those nice waves tomorrow. That's the only thing that I really worry when I'm doing the braid. Other than that, I don't really worry about if it comes out crooked, if it's not, you know, the same as the other one. Like, I'm going to sleep after this, so I don't care. My pillow doesn't judge me, so I'm fine. So yeah, I just do these, and then I've been using the little rubber bands. I used to use the big ones, but I noticed that when I use those, my hair it makes like these weird lines in them. So I've just been using the little tiny rubber bands like this. These ones here. So yeah, that's how I do it. And the other one I'm just gonna do off camera, because I mean, you already see me do one. You really don't need to see me. Okay, so now I have with my little braids. The next thing I do is take off my lashes. So that's how I usually take them out. And then if I see that there's anything in there that I don't like you see this glue, I just take it off right away. Just like, why just do them like that? Guys, I've been using these lashes, oh my god, since Thanksgiving, I think. And I washed them a few times already, and they're still amazing. Anyways, the next step is, by the way guys, sorry about that, like I told you guys, we switched the room, different color. It's still gray, just a different type, and it's a glossy gray. So I was cleaning that table, and I was cleaning like everything that's glass in here, like this is the dresser and it was glass, so I left the stuff there. And then yeah, anyways, so next thing I do, I've been getting a lot of stuff from my Ipsy bag. Like, I have a ton of these little things that I usually use when I travel. So I'm taking the big one, because I usually use the Clinique one. But I've been using this, and then I got this little brush. I got this at Bath & Body Works. No, not Bath & Body Works. Yeah, Bath & Beyond. And this is pretty much what I use. And then after I do this, I'm going to go ahead and do a mask. So I'll be right back. I have to go wash my face. Okay, so as you can tell, still swollen, especially this side, and I'm really red. And I had a bruise right here and right here, that's going away. So anyways, I was gonna do a mask. I got all these masks in here. But I remember I got this and I was like, you know what? It looks interesting. I want to try. I don't know for how long you put it on. Let's see. It's supposed to be make it brighter, evenly face, leave in for 10 to 15 minutes, rinse, clean with warm water for use on entire face or target areas. Tip. I don't know. Should I do this or should I do the other one? Which one should I do? So I'm gonna go ahead and do this one instead. And then tomorrow, I think I wanna do a sheet mask. This time that I was going through that, I don't know what, my body was acting up all kinds of crazy. I also got my period at the time, not too much info, but I started breaking out, so I have like some acne scars. Oh gosh, I don't want my lips. I'm going to put it right here. Oh, it smells so good. Okay, so I just applied all over my face. It's gonna take 15 minutes to 20 minutes to get it off. So I'll see you guys back when it's ready to take it off. Okay, so I have like 5 more minutes left, but I did this. I don't know. Have you guys ever used this? This is called a pore glow mask. It smells like peppermint. I was looking at the stuff that I have and I was like, okay, what am I gonna use to moisturize? Because like I told you guys, I have so many little things here that I get sent every month. And I was just like which one should I use? I have like water-based creams I wanted to show you. I have Tyndale Sunday Riley Brighten Intimate Water Cream. Then I have this Sympathy Beauty, a snow cream moisturizer. It's so cool because it actually looks like snow. Like that. And then I am going to be putting the, for under my eyes, for the wrinkles. It's called this skin. Okay, so I found another one. This is the Premise Organic Moisturizing Coconut Milk Face Lotion. I think I'm going to use this. And this one, this is for my under my eyes to brighten up my eyes, because I mean I have all really bad circles since the surgery. I really didn't get no sleep. So I mean, the first day they told me I was gonna be sleeping all day. No, I did not sleep. I mean, I did sleep, like I took a nap. I came home, my surgery was done at 10 in the morning. They started at 10:30. I got off because I took a Snapchat at 10:55, and then I got home like around 12:11 around there, because we had to go to the pharmacy. And then I came home, I drank water, I laid down, and we watched movies nonstop, and I think I took a nap if I did. And that's pretty much what happened the first day. It was just more like I was uncomfortable because of the gauze and my throat was super dry. And I had blood in my mouth. And I was like kind of scared because I was like, I don't know what the fuck is going on inside my mouth. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so that's what happened on the first day. I remember on the first day, I didn't want to eat anything. I think I had like one applesauce and I had ice cream. And I didn't have no food. I didn't want anything to eat. The next day, I did have some food. And the third day, I had smashed potatoes. Oh, my husband was his first time making them too. He did a pretty good job. But I'm just glad it's finally over and I'm just going to recovery. And the swelling has gone down quite a lot. So yeah, that's what happened on the... And then, yeah, the swelling got really bad on the third day. I was like, holy shit. And I start feeling the bruising already, and I'm like, oh yeah, I'm about to get bruised up. And yes, I did. I got bruised right here, bruised right here, here. The internal looked so bad. It looked like I was going bad. Because it was so bruised. Yeah. I really never put, like, this kind of mask that's just setting your face. Like, I usually put the ones that get hard or, you know, a little bit different. It's just like lotion all over my face, and I have to go wash it off with warm water. But hopefully it works, because I do need to brighten up my skin. I want to take care of my skin. For like the whole week, I was not wearing any makeup except for today and I think yesterday. I only put concealer, because I mean, I put concealer underneath here, and then I like dark spot corrector on this area because I had bruising. So it's kind of like, you know, I don't want people to think that or something. And then I put powder foundation all over my face just to blend everything together, and that was it. I didn't do no blush, no highlighter, no bronzer, none of that shit. I just put concealer, corrector, my eyebrows, my eyelashes, and I was gone. I think that's what I'm gonna do this week, or I might not even wear it to work, because I mean, they already know I went and got surgery, so I don't think anybody's gonna say something. And if they do, then I'll just be like, I got my teeth taken out, dude. Like, I of course wanna get freaking bruises. Something I've been feeling all day, and I don't know if this is normal, like underneath my head tongue, on the backside, it feels like it's sore. I don't know if it's because when I got my thing changed, my gauze, they put the thing, it was like kinda like it scraped me or what it is, but I'm like, oh, please don't let there be another complication to this thing. Cause yeah, it like hurts. Oh my god. Let me see what time it is.
It's 10:29.
It's time to go wash this off. I'll be right back. I'm back. I did notice that the redness went away. I love the way my skin feels, actually. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this right here. I like to put it just like that. It smells kind of weird. So I'm gonna go ahead and do it like that. And then using the ring finger, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and, is this to massage it? So this is what I'm gonna go ahead and do. Like, I put a little too much. So yeah, we went ahead and apply that. Then I'm gonna go ahead and add some of this Snow Screen Moisturizer. See what it's about. Just gonna dot here, a little bit of here. This actually feels really good. It's supposed to be like water based. The heck? It just dissolved. What happened yesterday? Yeah. I don't know if that's supposed to be part of it, but I'm gonna put the coconut milk. So I'm gonna go ahead and add the Promise Organic Nourishing Coconut Milk Facial Lotion with Hibiscus. I don't know. It's for combination skin. I'm gonna go ahead and add this. And at night, I love to put a lot, just because I'm going to bed. I have to moisturize my face. And then I do like to bring it down. I love the way this feels, honestly. So after that, you have to put chapstick on, girl. And that's pretty much what I do every night. I put a little bit of extra so you can tell. They're like super. Because after surgery, my lips were ugly and chapped. So I've been trying to moisturize them as much as I can. So this is getting done with me. So this is what I do. At the end of the night, I take all my makeup off. Do my braids. I try to take care of my skin. My lips were super chapped, so I have extra in there just to make sure they're super moist. And yeah, this is what I look like. So guys, I do want to thank you so much for watching this video if you made it to the end. If you didn't, I understand. Oh well. And don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll go ahead and put my social medias on the bottom. And I also have a channel with my husband. So yeah, guys. Thank you once again. Till next time. Para mala compañía, prefiero estar sola. Soy una reina y su destino controla. Quise que funcione, tengo a Dios como testigo. Mejor que siga su camino, que yo tengo el mío. Yeah.